a disease targeting women the world over, and now in India more than ever before. It's a silent killer that most don't discover before it is too late. Breast cancer. Anyone could be at risk, your mother, sister, friend, colleague, you, but despite this, there isn't much awareness of this disease. Now this is Breast Cancer Month, a fitting time to talk. And in a nutshell, although the range of factors causing this disease is not clear, the treatment for it certainly is. What's needed is early detection, efficient diagnosis, and quick action. And there is a hospital in India that specializes in just that. Want to know more? Let's go to Delhi.
Nestled in the busy West Delhi suburb of Rohini, the Rajiv Gandhi Cancer Institute has become a top spot for cancer care. In other parts of the city, it may seem like everything from the common flu to cancer requires endless rounds of clinics, hospitals, and chemists to complete tests and procedures. But RGCI is one of those that are changing the game. Since its inception in 1996, it has steadily procured top-of-the-line equipment and specialist doctors to provide care for all types of cancer. In particular, their breast cancer treatment is unmatched anywhere else in the country as a one-stop facility offering state-of-the-art diagnosis, treatment, and prognosis.
We thought that in case we make a comprehensive cancer hospital with all facilities under one roof, it will be a great service to the people of India. I do appreciate the concern that it costs huge amounts of money. So we haven't decided to outsource anything in our core area of activity, which is cancer diagnosis, cancer treatment, and cancer follow-up. And to have this kind of a comprehensive cancer hospital, we gave this project to one party. We wanted to give it to one party, and at that point in time we identified Siemens, because Siemens has diagnostic equipment, whether it is mammography, whether it is MRI. They also have linear accelerators to do the radiotherapy bit, so they could actually provide us with the maximum equipment that we needed for a hospital.
As you've admitted yourself, doctor, this has been a substantial investment. But has it really been an investment that is worthwhile, considering breast cancer rates in the country?
There's a lifetime risk of 1 in 10 women having breast cancer. Now, the trends have changed over the last few years so drastically in our country. In India, cancer cervix had the most frequency. Over the last couple of years, breast cancer has overtaken cancer of the cervix. Breast cancer is number one cancer in all our metropolitan cities. That's what the cancer registry show.
Now, before we get into the range of breast cancer treatment, first, let's learn a little bit about the disease. One can't really change that. Other factors one can do something about: excessive body weight, smoking, and the use of hormone therapy for postmenopausal women can add to your risk of contracting breast cancer. Probable symptoms for this disease could include a lump in the breast, discoloration or indentation of a part of the breast, discharge from the nipple, and unusual fullness or puckering. The best way to check for symptoms: self-examination. Go to a doctor for a physical examination as well, and go at least once a year if you are above 40. If you suspect something, consult a physician immediately.
Bringing various therapy facilities together. Well, I suppose sometimes it's not about being high-tech, it's just about being user-friendly that can make a difference. But in the case of cancer therapy, does that really make a difference? I mean, when a patient is suffering a potentially fatal disease, the convenience of the treatment is not the most important factor, is it? So, what's the answer? What's the best way forward for breast cancer therapy? Join us as we find out after the break.
Tubar.com.